along when they moving.
Rap it to my left, introduce yourself. Past state, sucker free, false.
Woo! You was a child calling your boys like, yo, let's go do some weed.
Sending me tracks like, yo, Pat, you should drop in this beat. Block and delete.
So they sleep outdoors in snowstorms and cook smoke troll with a blowtorch.
You're 29 years old, Gary. What the fuck are you doing with your life?
Cause he's so damn ugly, you think his mom and pops were Shaka Khan and Donkey Kong.
Just call a bitch up. If her pussy's as tight as your rhymes, then I'll just get my dick sucked.
Big slapping, his leg clapping. They call him Rampage Jackson.
The white Snoop Dogg, I could moonwalk with steel-toed boots on.
And Superman ain't losing to this fake crip tonight.
Wanting to smack you like the dad you never had right now.
So I'll let the nerd play Scrabble and strangle this burnt-faced bastard till he spells my first name backwards.
Wet William sucker since 86. Gangsta shit, bitch.
Barbarian, I skin wolves and rock the fur for survival.
Kicking a fucking soccer ball around and juggle the ball through all your rounds without it dropping on the ground.
I cheated on all my exams, so you already know. I got this shit in the palm of my hand.
In the cell across from you, just watching you as you eat a banana.
I came. That's a hard name.
Never confuse emotional with weak. I slit your throat with tears rolling down my cheek.
Lean, mean, sex machine.
You spawn, huh? I'll smack that tat off your face and smack it right back on you.
I am king of the dot. My name's embedded in that shit. If you really trap so much, you wouldn't open your trap so much.
You are not a man.
Tight hug, gang signs, I'm nice, cuz.
You got hoodies too, bro? Look at you go.
What's loyalty over money if your loyalty's overpriced?
I had a clear shot like Smirnoff. Should have smacked him upside his head, made it tilt like he's getting an eardrop.
What you know about being poor and all you got to eat is a gun.
You the greatest on your scene, I'm the greatest on the Atlas.
You dodged bullets on King of the Dot. I dodged bullets in real life. What's your life like?
If hands go up, I'm throwing mines like GoldenEye. Let them know.
You did it! Estimated time of delivery, 2 minutes.
Better line up some battles, because you spent it all on the machines trying to line up some apples.
Use the face recognition thing in case you get your phone stolen. Now only you and Hulk Hogan can get the phone open.
Hey, yo, Germany, make some fucking noise right now if you got AIDS.
He go on the father's blocks. Boy, calf muscles hard as rocks.
Maybe all your opponents pulling out last minute were trying to tell you something.
Fast, efficient. We'll call it decrypted.
What's he gonna do? Almost fight. Shut the fuck up.
You tap my pockets, I'm tapping back. Motherfucker, Shaq attack.
From King of the Dot to the smack stage, Pat stayed the exact same.
Basket case, put this snake charmer in the Cobra clutch. Listen.
The only compliment battle you can lose is a mirror match. The nicest.
And the new.
Hey yo, King of the Dot, put your money where your mouth is. Toronto, stay forever. Make some motherfucking noise for Pat, y'all. We got a crazy one about to go down. Battler to my right, introduce yourself.
Long live Paste, it's Frag, baby.
Battler to my left, introduce yourself.
What's up, y'all? SOCOM, fuck the police, fuck Israel, long live Paste.
Hey, yo. I need all y'all to hold it down again. Please don't talk when the rappers are rapping. Round one, it's on SoulCon. Let's go.
Check, 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 check. Y'all hear me? Yeah. Thank you. It's great to be here, y'all.
Yo.
Now, we got to talk about a whole long list of whack shit that you done. So everybody buckle up for Frack History Month.
Four. Now, for a lot of folks here, I'm the first battler you ever viewed, and now I'm here to make sure this is the last one that you ever do. There's... All right.
Wow. Thank you very much.
There's so much that I never knew. The fucking pathetic moves you make to get your likes and revenue. I am here to incinerate every single trace of your slimy residue. Motherfucker, I'm the end of you. Disaster had some things, and they need... He said to you that they need adapting, but... I did a little frack round check, and believe me, I had a... The puns will stop, I promise. Did a frack round check, and initially reacted in disbelief, but please believe when I say all this fuck shit really happened. But first, I gotta say, this is the only time you ever gonna see me capping. Hold up. He real dismissive because maybe he thinks he could outdo me. But best believe, bitch, you will never outdo me. Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu, Melech HaOlam, Asher Kidishanu, Mitzvot Tav Betzivanu, Lehit HaTev Vatsisi, let's fucking go. Bitch. You would do anything for a bag like counterfeit leather. Now your life's in jeopardy like a blind pedestrian surrounded by Teslas. You see, no matter what Freck might write, it's bound to be clever. But bitch, you'll never match my stripes even if we were in Auschwitz together. But he has angles.
Ooh, angles.
Bitch, I hope your angles are the most angular angles you ever wrote, because bitch, the angles of my approach are a Bengal tiger with both of its fucking fangs inside of your throat. And I don't need angles, I could just go direct. Man, my shit is a fatal blow that'll overload your dullest senses. I am so relentless, you gon' feel like I fucking drove a Lexus through your fucking solar plexus. But if shit gets so offensive, if the kid wants trouble, I seriously recommend you keep it hip-hop hustle. Because if you want to mix it up, I put your shit on shuffle. Have your x-ray looking like a jigsaw puzzle. Speaking of trying to make pieces fit, you piece of shit. Diz called you a Zionist. That means an Israel supporter. You deny the shit for further inquiries in order. So...
It's real. It's real. No pun intended.
Bitch, I have broken down and researched basically everything you talk about online. So if you're not a Zionist, then why is it that you literally have never fucking mentioned Palestine?
Yes, I have.
No results. One word. Gaza, no results. West Bank, no results. There's a trend here, isn't it? Palestinians are facing ethnic cleansing as we speak. You're never in the streets, but how the fuck can you mention that genocide in a fucking tweet? Bitch, I'm gonna say this. As Jews, it's our obligation to oppose the shit, but you ain't even posting shit, are you? Say free Palestine.
Free Palestine.
Say it with your chest, little Hebrew. Say it.
Free Palestine.
See, he's all hesitant, because he don't really talk about what happens in the West Bank or in Gaza, because nowadays he's afraid of scaring potential corporate sponsors. You never be using your platform, so whatever you think he stands for, entirely fake. You know what you got in common with the Zionist state? Both of you were a fucking giant mistake. My greatest weapon's my heart, like Izuku Midoriya. Bitch, you're dressed like a narc at the school from Euphoria. Everything you do is corny. I mean, what you actually still rapping more? The best you'll ever be is either Frack Lethal or Fracklemore. You knew it. Well, let's talk about that graph of yours, please. You remember the graph? Yeah, I remember when Disaster shredded the graph and Frack cleverly extracted a second intact and then had a punchline that was related to math. And the thing y'all really remember, the graph, right? Y'all remember the graph, right?
Yeah.
Cue the Undertaker music. Because that graph went viral. It gave him pumped and played his music, helped him cultivate his movement. Shit, I was even proud as if you were my favorite student. That graph idea was great, right? Yeah, because I fucking gave it to him.
I got the DMs right here, bitch.
Hey, that's not true. It's not true. It's not true. Not true. Not true. Not true.
Shrek, I am not an opponent you can fight, because basically I can't.
Oh, make some noise. Yeah. The kid's got guts.
Homie, I am not an opponent you can fight, because basically I gave you the biggest moment of your life.
No.
So regardless of the garbage that you kicked in me, Frack, after today, you will never get your dignity back. But away from you, you're wrong. Yo, Ron. Ron, I heard you flirting with me, baby. Last night we heard it. We heard it. Listen, I know you were a king of the dot, but boy, look but don't touch. Because these inches I got are guaranteed to crush your boy pussy to dust. Thank you very much. Let's fucking go.
Rare one, it's on Frack. Let's go.
Hey, yo.
Stay forever.
Make some noise, Toronto.
Yeah, don't trip on anything.
Hey, I say, yo.
Thank you, sorry, yo.
I say, yo, it is Free Palestine. Mm-hmm. I don't support Israel, Doomsday included, but you coming out as bisexual, was that your two-state solution? Hey, I say, yo, and that Auschwitz bar was a perfect cliffhanger. Stop acting like we're oppressed. We're not up against a German dictator. Our ancestors were Wu-Tang. They entered the 36 chambers. Hey, but he remembered how to rap. Even pulled a few flows. You were cooking too, bro. Look at Jugo. Yo. Hey, I say, yo, I knew some fans gon' hate on this shit. The SJ Double Jews as a co-main event. The SJ Double Jews is a co-main event, but nah, this is Old Bay and Biscuits versus No Flavor Chicken. This is Don't Play the Victim versus Gold-Plated Privilege. This the dope on the counter versus the cocaine addiction. This the dope on the counter versus the cocaine addiction. Con, we not the same. Every snowflake is different. Listen. Hey, they only gonna react because last time you were here, you needed CPR training. Fuck seeing stars. Diz had you seeing stars at David. Thank Pat or... Hold up. Had you seeing stars of David, thank Pat Organic and me for being all patient. Cause we giving soul a second chance like reincarnation. Embrace it. At the Diz battle, I said Jewish pride, I'll take your side. I even stayed till it ended, all day and night. First round, they were like, woo, Khan taking flight. Second round, they were like, shit, maybe Kanye was right. I mean, hold up, let me keep going. Maybe Kanye was right. Bro, you were out there rapping at TED Talk speeds, and you died in that third round. We were like, let Khan breathe. Killed by Diz, killed by A-Ward. Now the bet's on me. This must be what Kanye meant by Death Con 3. Dog, please. That battle lasted 40 days. That shit lasted 40 nights. We watched a Jew die for 3 hours like the Passion of the Christ. Hold up! My grandma lived through the Holocaust and actually survived. She watched that battle and said, this is the worst thing that's happened in my life. Yikes.
It's fucking...
As a Jew, that battle was my personal 9/11. Look at the way it hurt us all. Everything that could go wrong did go wrong. Murphy's Law, I woke up to a burning cross. I woke up to a burning cross. Chick-fil-A stopped serving sauce. A bunch of Jews converted, saw him worship in the church and mosque. It pissed Kyrie Irving off. Hold up. Hold up. Fuck. I said, I woke up to a burning cross. Chick-fil-A stopped serving sauce. A bunch of Jews converted, saw him worship in the church and mosque. It pissed Kyrie Irving off. It's the reason Bernie lost. It's the reason Bernie lost. The Holocaust no longer Germans' fault. They remodeled the Berlin Wall. John was like, word is bond. John was like, word is bond. In Wuhan, a person coughed. Mind you, all this shit happened before y'all got your third verses off. Word to God. Bro, your name's Noah. Yeah. Noah, that's who you're titled after? Well, you bring shame to the ancestors, the Torah, the Bible's chapters. Your career arc got washed up inside the rapture. The one thing Noah's supposed to do is survive disaster. But it's Frank Hoffa. It's Frank Hoffa. Hey. So this is how Brooklyn do? Every time I look at you, I want to put a fist, knife, bullet, or a foot in you. I was so tired of the way you made them look at Jews, so I stepped up and beat Diz. Shit, I did what you couldn't do. Look at you. Look at you. I took a Jewish man's mitzvahs and updated it with bars. I'm beyond soul caliber. I put a blade into your heart. They had a vet on a minimum and traded for a star. Kyrie going to the Mavs. This is the changing of the guard. You never had bars. Your whole pen is lame. Two bar setups with internet jokes thrown in the fray. Your style like them kicks in the old NBA. Cause soul's worn down and Converses don't hold up today. So, A. Hey. Who the fuck am I?
Who the fuck am I?
Converses don't hold up today. So, A, hey, don't try and father me like Warbucks, like your Lux. This is the first battle I ever had where I'm more buff. So let's warm up. This is the first battle I ever had where I'm more buff. So let's warm up. Get the ab work, your core cut, or it's purgatory. Soul stuck, take the small slice, shortcut, or the long road, tour bus. Either way, take the small slice, shortcut, or the long road, tour bus. Either way, soul gets split seven ways like a horcrux, or what? Hey, bring out all the files you want. You can't rap like that. Hey, like a horcrux or what? You lost to A-War, couldn't roast a Christian. Annie's ginger, soul was missing. Give me space. You lost to A-War, couldn't roast a Christian. Annie's ginger, soul was missing. Give me space, social distance. All these marks can get it. Socialism, bow, bow. I said all these marks can get it. Socialism, bow. I'm in pole position, wow. Owen Wilson, Param. You lost to A-Ward, couldn't roast a Christian. Annie's ginger, soul was missing. Gimme space, social distance. All these marks can get it. Socialism, bow, I'm in pole position. Wow, Owen Wilson, paramedics at your door, trying to save soul like Jehovah's Witness. Listen. Listen, you high on coke if you think you letting firearms go. This shit go right through soul like Zion's toe. You told war like Zion's toe. This shit go right through soul like Zion's toe. You told Ward you could do parkour in Rockport, Oxfords. Right on, bro. Well, Pat taught me to moonwalk with steel toe boots on. Translation, we slide on soul. Time. That's one. That's one.
Hey, yo, round two, it's on SoulCon. Let's go.
Now, my bisexuality ain't something that I will often rap about. But my real two-state solution is taking your girl ass to mouth.
Yeah.
He was like,
like beating his chest about beating Diz, really feeling himself. But you just admitted in my last round that you fucking needed my help.
Okay, fine.
Well, when it comes to music, I know you're versatile, of course, you know, but that imagination of yours ain't very fertile of resource. But the style that you're rhyming with isn't personally yours. You just copying what's popping and then do it worse and really force it. I listen to his tracks. Y'all won't get very far. This is how Frack sounds on every song on every bar. Bitch, you listen to my fucking music when you were a child.
Thank you very much. That was very sweet of you.
Bitch, I bet in your mind you think you sound like a Kendrick Lamar. No, you sound like a toddler that was left in a car. You only measure your arts as an investment for some gains. Like how you made that project full of song titles with celebrity names in hopes that they would notice it and post it online and propel you to fame. Now you've just been reduced to sealing other rappers' songs without a second of shame. For instance, he just dropped a song called ASMR. That's just what I mean, because that's something that 21 Savage did in 2018. Now,
21, can you do something for me? Is there nothing Frack won't do for money?
I've been on your Instagram.
Oh, look. I've been on your Insta and your girlfriend is ugly.
No. Oh, my God, she's beautiful.
Okay. See, I sustained a fan base by relating to how they're living. You're just a yappy Pomeranian chasing an algorithm. Is it worth going viral being a forgettable shill? See, you and Gregory Poe remind me of Ellie and Joel, because you're his surrogate child who will never be ill.
Y'all watched Last of Us, right? It's good. So, yeah, thank you. Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
And that ain't even the thing, that, by the way, that ain't the same first shit that Frack stolen before. You know, you stay incredibly cocky, given the fact that even in your approach to Diz, you plagiarized Oxy. And then, by the way, that ain't the only other thing he's stolen before. Your wedding angle with fucking Danny, that was Sharon versus Ward. But, from Jew to Jew, I'm sorry to say, you about to be cremated. Ironic is a teenager, he majored in creative writing, but it seems they never told him that in order to be created, somebody had to be the one to actually create it. And it gives me no joy and no pride to silence this boy, but I have to do it with the voice of a Goliath like Keith David. You know Gargoyles, Keith David. I know this shit is live, but when you replay this, probably make the same face as the WeeBay GIF. Bitch, I keep it real, he just... You know I keep it real while he shapeshifts. See, people hear my name and they think of certain classics, like when they see me versus Madness. People hear your name and they think burrito versus sandwich.
Fire.
I gave this culture my sweat, and it's felt to this day, while you owe it a debt that you will never repay.
You know, right, okay, all right.
What you do is this whole marketing plan, this is what he does. You repost your battle clips on TikTok, leeching for millions, but you don't ever tag or promote the leagues that actually fucking film them. Like ever. But if it was a cartoon from your Jagoff fucking Jagoff channel, I bet you'd be sure to tag the fucking rap off battle. Because that's the only fucking money that you make it from. I wish that your next time you have an asthma attack, you inhale your fucking tongue, you won't break with fucking scum.
Alright. Sorry.
See, Ilmac and Pass get a pass because they've been actually contributing. But these cartoons you do are fucking plastic and gimmicky. You made, for the cheese, you made a fucking craft look like a laughable industry. This is shit is the worst since the epic rap battles of history. Wait, you do that corny shit too, don't you? Well, finally, I understand how I can accurately liken Frack to fracking. See, this is how you do it, because like fracking, Frack extracts from the scene without any regard for the damage it leaves, just for the ravenous greed for the gas that it needs. Bitch, I brought fans in this scene. You ain't no one in it. You think this shit's a stepping stone? I'll cave your skull in with it. Are you a backpacking nerd or Andy Samberg? Decide on one. Motherfucker, you like Lonely Island? I hope you die on one. Bitch. And by the end of the next round, by the time it's done, the only gas you'll be wishing for is Zyklon, son.
Hey,
I say, yo,
I say, can y'all hear me? Check. Yo, 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 y'all good? We good? I say, yo, when you thought of that Last of Us bar, did you press shift and send? Mm-hmm. This is like The Last of Us. The game man kills himself in the end. Bye, my bad. Hey. Wait, not the end. It's like episode 7. Hey. Hey. And you know what? That fracking bar was decent, but paid a price. Your frequency ain't as right. Maybe you're the one who's been fracking, because all these years you've been secretly laying pipe. What? Pause, my bar, my best man. Pause. Hey. But anyway. I love the fact you're bisexual. You came out as bisexual. Make some noise. Way to lead your life. Equal rights. Then I remembered you asked Diz for a kiss. Jesus Christ, is he your type? I feel you. But of all the homophobic shit you said, nothing was better than I quote, "It's no wonder Fresco and Faggot have the same number of letters." Wow, what a simple, genius way for stuff to get measured. Why do we even need public defenders? Gonna, guilty, same number of letters, put him under forever. We can even learn things about ourselves, our lovers, their gender. Wait, soul kind? Bisexual? It's all coming together. An old Jewish man coming out. You have my respect for you. But what does that make you? Rabbi. What? An old Jewish man coming out. You have my respect for you. But what does that make you? Rabbi sexual. Rabbi sexual. I remember you on that grind time run. You were dominant, vicious. And when you were being all homophobic, woo! You really knew how to conjure an image. I'm talking hot guys, locked eyes, and all the positions. Even then, I was like, huh, these scenarios are oddly specific, but I get it. The same gay slurs over and over. You were finding a fine line. Knew the truth deep down. You were bi trying to buy time. Wanted to be oppressed so bad. You were blind to the bylines. You put the menorah in minority and grinder in grind time. My God. Yo, when you came out, you said, "Since childhood, I've known about my sexual preference." Just covering it up from the inside like September 11th. So when you battled Fresco, you were talking to yourself in reflection. And all that homophobic shit was at best a deflection of the inner self you neglected, a weapon you kept for protection like the Second Amendment. A weapon you kept for protection like the Second Amendment. You won those battles by being loud with your pent-up aggression. But that's not the reason Grind Time listed your strength as projection. But question, what? But question, when you came out, that must have been a whirlwind, dog. But then I come to find out you have a girl. I said, when you came out, that must have been a whirlwind, dog. But then I come to find out you have a girlfriend. No, but then I come to find out you have a girlfriend. Pause. Hey, pause. Hey, yo, no hetero, but that's what you about? Hey, yo, no hetero, but that's what you about? How many times have you even sucked dick?
About 4 or 5.
4 or 5? I say 3 because the disaster battle doesn't count. Wow. Wow! Wow! Don't fall for it! Stop falling for it! The disaster battle doesn't count! Wow! See, coming out the closet was your perfect way out. Like, how could I be homophobic 10 years ago? I'm gay now. Expose yourself before we ask like a perverted 8 Mile, knowing in the future you'd be canceled like a 30-day trial. Wow. Just because you're bi now, you think they'd forgive and forget it today? No. Trying to pull a Kevin Spacey like, it's all right, fellas, I'm gay. It's all right, fellas, I'm gay. You built your audience off all of this. The intentions were plain. You came out the closet. Your skeleton stayed back in the day. Back in the day, you were the homophobic goat. Now you want to go by? And he wants forgiveness for his past, but view it from both sides. Imagine Hitler on trial. Like, Adolf, why did you ruin those folks' lives? And he's like, it's chill, guys. I was Jewish the whole time. Bro, why? He said he was gonna 30 me.
Oh, no, I did not.
Hey, Jewish the whole time. Bro, why? Because you said you were progressive back then, and all those bars exaggerated. So he didn't believe what he said. He just wants the crowd to praise him. Your biggest moment ever was a file with a parking violation. It makes sense. He did it all for validation. Face it. The first to do a background check on a battle rapper, collecting refunds and receipts, like a parking ticket on QP proved he wasn't a street. On Twitter all day is defund the police. But in battle rap, bro, he was the police. Sheesh, and still is. Big. He was the police. Sheesh, the battle rap traffic cop. This fool is tapped in. At the parking lot, watching QP as he backs in. Cop, don't touch me, cop. At the parking lot. Watching QP as he backs in. Nitty says he wants to smoke. Sir, is that a wax pen? Pulled up to Twerk's whip. Sir, are you strapped in? Snitch boy, he's an innovator. Khan is an artist. Kid Slade, Adi Boom, this is where all of it started. Snitch boy, they say don't tell a soul because they'll call the department. A Khan was a cop the whole time, like the plot of Departed. But I got it. But I got a file in my hand. I got a file in my hand. Yeah, this shit fell in my lap. I did some research like you, just to dig up your past. And what's in here could make your whole career end in a crash. And I only brought one, cause I know we too bitch to ever rip it in half. So when I open this file, this gonna put him under some pressure. Soul Con and Policeman have the same number of letters. What? That exposed. Hey, save that whack ass exposing shit, man. This is real evidence. A policeman.
Final round, it's on SoulCon. Make some noise, y'all.
Sorry, I'm all fucked up. I'm gonna try to salvage some shit. Did y'all know that Frack's half Latino? Well, at least that's what we know. At least that's where he goes around telling people so they don't think that he's just some bland average gringo, but mijo. I'm really sorry I have to break this to you. I know that your mom came from Peru, but both of her parents are Romanian Jews. Ain't that shit true?
One is.
Okay. But that means that
overall,
white people...
Phenomenal research, though.
Overall, white people, right? But I just bring that up to embarrass you. I mean, maybe there's a second Romania in Central America. Romania. Let's check real quick. Nope, still in Europe. So it's been determined
You're as Latino as me, bro. You're as Hispanic as Gannick. Right. And in his head, he might be thinking, but she was born and raised in, motherfucker, if I flew out of a white vagina in Shanghai, China, that doesn't make me Asian. This needs no more explaining. All right, dude? You're a white dude. Not Bad Bunny, you're Dwight Schrute. Now, every frack history month ends with an important holiday. It's in honor of a young man named Jordan Holloway, but now he was frack's biggest fan and he totally existed. And he loved to say supportive shit like, homie, you're the shiznit. And his favorite thing to do was hearing things in your quotes. So man, let's take a second to break down some shit that you wrote. Frack said on his song Draymond, you got more bodies on cam than a racist cop. What in the Iggy Azalea make it stop? Now, besides the abusive use of tragic imagery, the real rap epiphany that shocks and amazes that saying racist cop implies that there's a cop that's not racist.
Like you.
Do y'all? Wait, is there a cop that's not racist?
You!
The thing we're meeting?
My bad.
I mean, you keep calling me cops, but kill all the laughter. I was standing like 50 to 1,000 against a rally for Blue Lives Matter. I risked my fucking safety. You stayed home like a baby, so stop calling me a cop before you need someone to take you out of the fucking venue and I'll break all of your legs, dude. Do not call me a cop. Do not call me a cop. That's real shit, bro.
Noted.
Thank you. Sorry.
I got you.
It's traumatic, if you will. All right. As if there isn't a racist cop, right? There's a racist cop. But see, the reason I just think it's funny you saying that dumb shit, because your breakout battle was all about racial justice. Y'all seen his battle with Coma? I'll summarize it
if
those
of us
didn't. He focused on privilege and the racial disparities in the way people are going to prison. But the one thing that fucked me up is when you told him that he chose his addiction. He chose his addiction. Bitch, that is how I know your existence was always sheltered from harm and that you never saw one of your homies with a belt on his arm or never worried that they were fucking dead or just slept in their car or worried that they OD'd and you were a fucking second too far. But I guess they don't make a TikTok character for that. See, life ain't give me lemons, it planted some ghost peppers. My mother's got cancer, my daddy's a cult member. So that's why when you judge Danny as a father, man, that man works even way harder than any dad that I've known ever. But your dad, for example, writes children's books. That's fucking sweet as can be. All my dad did was give me PTSD. But I guess there's no TikTok character for that. Mm. Bitch, I wouldn't even be here if it weren't a charitable act, even if there were a fucking barrel at my back. You about to see me snap like Derek Jeter's bat, just a biter versus lighter with the kerosene attached.
There we go.
Comparing me to Frack. Man, apparently Frack is embarrassed to be Frack. You hide behind a barrier of characters you hatch to keep yourself distracted from the character you lack.
That was fire. Thank you.
And I ain't even getting to the ugly punchlines you had about shit like Chadwick Boseman's cancer growing or how you use a Black Lives Matter as promotion for Macaulay Culkin. You fucking single while the rest of us were actually at the protest, getting sprayed, peppers, mace, tased, arrested. Man, motherfucker, you know how I promoted my shit during that moment in history? I fucking didn't. And that's why we're fucking different. Here's an idea for a rap contest, a rap-off contest, and I don't even want to tag. It'll be like this. Frack's willingness to do anything to get a check versus Frack's, sorry, lack. Sorry, y'all, I'm cotton mouth as fuck. Thank you. I was gonna say, I'm sorry, Pat. I'll do better next time, motherfucker. I promise.
Thanks, man.
That's fine. It's all good. You killed it, man.
Yeah,
you did phenomenal. You still got a round left.
Well, that was good.
Oh, no, that was going to be hitting me. Mine.
You want to finish it?
It's all good. No.
I feel it. Check, check.
Final round. It's on Frack. Let's get it.
Check. Can you hear me? Check. Turn me up. I feel like Frack's willingness to get a check won that battle. Hey!
That was parlay.
Nah, that was a dope round. Hey, I took this battle on some positive shit. I took this battle to thank you for letting me know that anything is possible. I learned a lot from you, because your career was my blueprint of exactly what not to do. See, all my successes are lessons you taught to me. Don't go unlimited rounds with disaster. Stop at threes. Stop at threes. Don't act above battle rap for 9 years, mock the scene, and come crawling back as soon as your career lost some steam. Don't give up on the music, don't rhyme off the beat, don't fool the fans out their money, that's cons artistry. See, don't fool the fans out their money, that's cons artistry. See, Noah got washed up, but Moses parts the sea. I'm the evolution. Noah got washed up, but Moses parts the sea. I'm the evolution of soul like R&B. Come on, my G. Come on, my G. This isn't some shot, so don't try and approach me as master. You're rounding 40 with no prospects, not even close to a rapper. Right now, this is the moment you matter, and I'm closing a chapter. So passing your legacy down to me is the only way soul been a factor. Ask him. Is the only way soul been a factor? Ask him. So then he tried politics. Ran for District 45 congressman as a Democrat, but the bi part of him's bipartisan. But then the media started roasting him and he called it quits. Who you? The Electoral College dropout? I know. The Electoral College dropout? I know Khan is pissed. The New York Post found your old battles, old tweets. They posted all of it. It's funny. Your politics won't let you make it in battle rap, and your rap battles won't let you make it in politics. See, he had a midterm crisis. Couldn't get in. Let me rap. He had a midterm crisis, couldn't get the comments out his conscience. He was closing up the cabinet after coming out the closet. You were supposed to run too, but you said, fuck you, I'll count my losses. We supposed to run the media. You let him run you out of office, I promise. He dissed Kobe the day he died, like you don't give a fuck, but deletes his Twitter the next day as soon as folks lit him up. See, when his feelings are stressful and the road's getting tough, it's a deal with the devil. Soul, giving up, listen up. Why do you deserve forgiveness for your old days? But people who aren't you know they can't grow nor change. It's like the movie Coco, cause soul gon' fade. See, karma's just like you. It goes both ways, okay? What? What? It goes both ways, okay? Quits battles, quits elections, quits making records, quits Twitter, anything where he can't take the pressure. Rest in peace to Pat, the greatest ever, a legacy that they'll remember. Cowards leave when it gets tough. Legends stay forever. So, rest in peace. Legends stay forever. So whenever you say you've changed as a person, I don't believe in that shit. When you still out here using the same deceitful tactics. Your whole A-word battle was Jesus, Catholics, Easter baskets, priests and Baptists. The same stereotypical shit through your new beliefs reimagined. Same with all the tweets he's drafting, wreaking havoc in your reading glasses, yelling at neoclassists and eco-fascists because you're ego-fragile and you need reaction. It's just... Yelling at neoclassists and eco-fascists because his ego fragile and he needs reaction. It's just the same way of talking down on people, reenacted. It's just the intellectual version of calling people Bleep again it. But you really think, you really, right up, nah, I'm good. You really think you're this different person from Grind Time? Shit, I'm not hearing that.
But if you are, what would the two of you sound like in a mirror match? See, that Soul Khan's like I'm the original fucking Jew. And this Soul Khan's like that language makes me uncomfortable. I said, that Soul Khan says, I'm the original fucking Jew. And this Soul Khan's like, that language makes me uncomfortable. And that Soul Khan calls you a SJW. And this Soul Khan's like, how dare you? You're insufferable. And that Soul Khan can't stand you. Who let this couple through? And this Soul Khan don't recognize him. Like, what's this coming to? And that Soul Khan is standing right in front of you like, I'm Soul Khan, you silly bitch. Who the fuck are you? What?
Feel me, Smack? Hey, that was my last bar, but I'm gonna add one because I thought you did really good.
Nah, man, I fucking fell apart. My shit got fucked up.
Hey, so I think you coming out was for Pat. It was your way to say bye. I think you coming out was for Pat. It was your way to say bye. Mazel tov on living your truth. In the words of Pat Stay, gay pride.
Make some motherfucking noise for Soul Khan and Frack, y'all.
It was amazing, bro. That's probably, I'm still like in the vibe, but I'm like, that was probably the most amazing feeling. Like the energy because of Pat Stay and everyone who came to support was so like, oh man, the energy in this room is just like so wonderful. I was really nervous before, as you can attest to. I was scared of Soul Khan's angles. I was scared of not like disrespecting Pat by not having my best performance. But I'm so happy. Like, I feel like I executed on everything I wanted to, you know?
I forgot how consuming this stuff can be to your life in a manner of ways. And I feel like this has been a negotiation between what I feel is morally acceptable in terms of meanness and what is just sort of like the what we're used to in battle rap, because things can feel and sound super high stakes and serious. And I could say some real cruel thing tonight, and in a day, do I wish ill on anyone I battle? Very rarely.
Honestly, it was the same three angles. Like, first round, just rapping good, talking about the Diz battle, talking about being Jewish. Second round, bisexual. Third round, about him always quitting and giving up on everything. But it was all the lighthearted version of it. Like, we're here for Pat. We're here to celebrate. I'm just two Jews, kind of similar politically. Like, let's just have fun. But then when he was saying shit like I'm going to rip his head for the sake of hip hop, and like he's gonna want to quit battle rap for this, like that type of shit, like brought me to that next level. I was like, if that's the energy you want to be on, we can be on that.
I told Frack before this, I was like, because I hit him up privately, or he hit me up privately, because I wrote something to the effect on Twitter of like, I've been told not to hold anything back and I will oblige. And he's like, oh wow, man, you really gonna go hard like that? And he's like, I was gonna go lighthearted for the event. And I was like, yeah, don't do that. You know, because I'm swinging in very personal ways. And what motivated that partly just because, like, that's an aspect of what Pat would do. You know, he cut at the core of people.
So he did some great research, almost a little bit creepy amounts of research. Like, he really dug in there. But I think my defense of pulling out my file and being like kind of in like a satirical way of like exposing people as dumb. Soul Khan and Policeman have the same number of letters, you know. That was my way of like that was my way of like predicting that and like softening all his angles and calling him a cop.
You see, the thing is, like, I started getting into the sort of YouTube battle scene before I really knew about Pat or was that acquainted with him. But he, as I saw what he did, I was like, oh, you really can just take this art form into some really unpredictable but not like esoteric places. You know, you can be conversational in like a very artful way. You could be like, you can be funny in a way that still feels like a punch in the face. So he brought a lot of different shades of humor, and just, I don't know, like I've he's one of those people I felt like broadened the possibilities of what battle rap could and should be.
That's what he gave to me.
You know, check out my music, check out my skits. Now, Sokan talked about this shit. So he said, Sokan said that I do shit for a check, like that I do everything for a check. I'm like, man, if I'm selling myself out for a check, I should be doing way better than I am, man. But spread the love, buddy. But nah, check out my music, check out the rap cartoons that he talked about. Check out my skits at Frack the Person. And rest in peace to Pat Stay, man. Thank you for, like, honestly, what an honor to honor one of my biggest inspirations with probably my best performance. So, love you, Pat.
What up, suckers? Pat Stay. AKA Sucker Free Bonk. Taka XO. Get me John's lunch, give me 445. You ready for this? Hell no, I got you. Fucking Gary, 29 years old. Pat Stay raps all the mastermind. Exaggerated bit, but Patrick saves the shit. I don't want to battle no more. I just want to relax.
Shuts down my dead homies. Suckers! I'm just joking. See ya!